can you tell me what do you know about immunodeficiencies? What the word immunodeficiency is showing you? What comes first to your mind when you are seeing immunodeficiency? Yes. That means we are going to discuss about some diseases. In that diseases there will be deficiency of immune system, there will be compromise of immune system. Okay, so what are the cells that are performing immune they are performing their activity in immune system? Those are the B cells, T cells and macrophages, NK cells, monocytes. Okay, so there are two kinds of immunities. We have already discussed that, innate immunity and adaptive immunity. The B cells and T cells are the important or pivotal for the adaptive immunity, while for the innate immunity there are monocytes, macrophages, eosinophils, basophils and NK cells. Okay, so now we are going to discuss these B cell disorders. We have already discussed these, but I will do a revision of these B cell disorders, because these are very important. The first of them is X-linked Bruton aghemoglobulinemia. Okay, this is X-linked Bruton aghemoglobulinemia. This is named Bruton because maybe Bruton was a scientist, and he also named the gene that is defective in this disease. I already told you that any enzyme that is deficient, that means there is any kind of gene deformity, because all the enzymes are proteinaceous nature, the genes give rise to protein. Okay, yes, here defect is in the BTK gene. Okay, which is a tyrosine kinase gene. That means BTK is the Bruton tyrosine kinase. Okay, defect in the Bruton tyrosine kinase, that means it is a tyrosine kinase gene that is defective, that is helpful for the B cell maturation. Actually, B cell inside a germinal center or inside a follicle, inside a lymph node, B cell undergoes many different maturation stages. Okay, if any one of them has got halted or any one of them has got captured at place, that means B cell will not get mature. And here right now we are going to face the defective gene, that is BTK gene. Okay, that is Bruton tyrosine kinase. Actually, tyrosine kinases are enzymes. Okay, tyrosine kinases are enzymes. Tyrosine kinases perform the roles, perform the enzymatic role in the cell signaling pathway. Okay, in any cell there is signaling pathway of that cell. Okay, that signaling pathway is also being performed by some enzymes that are named as tyrosine kinase. And once again, this tyrosine kinase is also important for maturation of B cell in lymph nodes. Okay, we have discussed that in lymph node there are two kinds of follicles. One is primary follicles, where inactive B cells are lying, and another one is active follicle, secondary follicle, where active B cells are lying. Okay, primary follicle and secondary follicle. Primary follicles means inactive B cells, and secondary follicle means active B cells. These active B cells have to undergo so many maturation stages that they can form ultimately into a plasma cell, that is factory for producing antibodies. Okay, moving ahead, there will be no B cell maturation, and it is X-linked recessive. Once again, I have already told you that X-linked recessive conditions are more common in boys. They have more increased risk in boys because the girls are getting 1x from mother, 1x from father. If one of them is normal, that means the girl will be normal for her life. Okay, but the boy is only getting one gene, 1x from only his mother. Okay, if that mother is defective with that gene, if that gene is lone gene is defective, that means boy will be defective. Okay, this is the case here. All the two boys in the family are defective right now. Okay, while girls can get one capital X gene here. I have just wrote it wrong. Okay, just so we can observe that both girls are having one X capital from their mother. We can just make, okay, we can just make like X, that is this XY. I have made something wrong. Just give me a second. Okay, this is X capital. Now this is right. X small X capital X, that is here small X capital X, small X capital X, small X capital Y. Okay, small X capital X, small X capital Y. That means all the girls who are getting one normal gene there from their father are being normal for their life, but these two boys are defective with the gene. Okay, that this pattern is called as recessive pattern. Either it could be with the sex-linked hormone, sex-linked chromosomes that are X and Y, that it could be X-linked, that it could be X-linked recessive or autosomal recessive. Right now, this is X-linked recessive, that is X-linked Bruton aghemoglobulinemia. The name itself is showing X-linked. Okay, that means it is going to be more common in boys. And moving ahead, presentation is that recurrent bacterial and enteroviral infections after 6 months. Normally what is happening, these B cells are going to get mature and produce B cells, produce plasma cells. That plasma cells will be able to secrete so many antibodies, and those antibodies are responsible for neutralizing the different pathogens. Among those pathogens, the bacteria and enteroviruses are the main ones, are the important ones. Okay, we have to keep this enteroviral infection in mind, because enteroviral infection is only related to this condition from all these immunodeficiencies. Okay, we cannot find enterovirus in any of these immunodeficiency except this X-linked beta X-linked Bruton aghemoglobulinemia. This is also simply called as XLA. You can remember it as XLA. Okay, in MCQs we just the people just write is that as XLA. Okay, X-linked aghemoglobulinemia. Okay, so we will get recurrent bacterial infections because there are no antibodies in our body present that can neutralize these pathogens. Okay, normally these antibodies are neutralizing these pathogens, and right now plasma cells are not present. That's why antibodies will not be secreted, and ultimately these bacteria will roam around and cause bacterial and enteroviral infections. And these are happening after 6 months. That is because the only immunoglobulin, the only antibody that is passed from the mother into the fetus is IgG. Okay, that is called as maternal IgG. This maternal IgG is available to the fetus or to the newborn for at least 6 months. After 6 months, when these maternal IgG bodies are going to be finished, the baby will show symptoms. That's why often in scenarios we will get 7 month old boy, 8 month old boy, 9 months old boy, 12 months old boy. Okay, after 6 months we have to, especially there will be 7 month old boy case. Okay, you have to keep that thing in mind. That is just because the maternal IgGs are preventive. Okay, these findings will be on the scenario that absent B cells in the peripheral blood, because the B cells are not going to mature. That's why they will be absent, and decreased IgG, that decreased immunoglobulins of all classes, absent or scanty lymph nodes. I have already told you that B cells develop in the primary and secondary follicles of the lymph nodes. Now, since B cells are not getting mature, that's why these lymph nodes will get absent or scanty. This is called as kind of disuse. Okay, this is kind of law of disuse. That theory you must have read and studied in biology in your school time. That law of disuse and use by Charles Darwin. Okay. So that means when you are using some, like you are muscling up, you are doing gym every day, you will get I will get bulkier. Okay, that means I am using my muscles again and again. If I am not using my muscles again and again, that means I will get floppy, I will not develop the muscles. That's why if we are not having B cells mature in our body, these lymph nodes will get scanty or absent, and also these tonsils will also get absent. The primary follicles and germinal centers in the tonsils, because tonsils are present in your mouth and lymph nodes are present all over your body. These two are secondary lymphoid organs that are responsible for maturation of these are actually houses of B cell. Okay, since the person who is living in the house is not present, that's why the government will sanction this house, okay? That's why body will sanction this house, that's why these will be absent in your body. Both primary or secondary, because this is primary follicle and secondary follicles are characteristics of actually germinal centers are actually characteristics of secondary follicle, okay? So the writer of this book has just changed the wording, secondary follicle, okay? These germinal centers, both the primary follicles and secondary follicles will get degenerated, okay? Since these germinal centers are present in secondary follicles, these germinal centers have an other name that is called secondary follicle. You can use vice versa, like germinal center is equal to secondary follicle. This is your secondary follicle has another name that is germinal center. You can just use it, okay? And moving ahead, in this patient live vaccines are contraindicated. Why in this patient live vaccines are contraindicated? Let me tell you this thing once again, okay? For suppose, what is the mechanism of vaccination which we are using in our cases is that, for suppose this is a bacteria or a pathogen, okay? This is a pathogen, okay? And we are going to heat this pathogen so that this pathogen could become negative, could become inactive. This line is showing for suppose inactivity, okay? Now after heating up, this pathogen became inactive, but this pathogen is still live, okay? Still alive. What we will do, this inactivated pathogen, we will put this pathogen in a syringe and we will put into the patient's body, okay? Into the patient's blood. After reaching in this blood, this inactive pathogen, what this inactive pathogen will do, it will induce B cells to produce antibodies through a mechanism, okay? What this inactive pathogen will do, can you tell me? Okay, let me draw this once again. For suppose this is a patient's body, okay? This is patient's blood, okay? And we have got this pathogen, okay? And we are going to heat this pathogen right now. We have put this pathogen on heat so that this pathogen could become inactive, okay? After making this pathogen passive, we will put this pathogen into the blood of person A, okay? Okay, now after inserting this pathogen, this inactive pathogen, what this inactive pathogen will do, it will not harm your body, but instead this pathogen will cause B cells to get active so that B cells could make antibodies against this pathogen, okay? And these antibodies will neutralize this pathogen, okay? They will kill up this pathogen by different mechanisms, and these antibodies will be present forever in your blood for the whole lifetime, for suppose. Now whenever any pathogen which is similar to this is going to enter in your body due to any cause, these antibodies are already present to kill this pathogen, okay? That is the whole mechanism of active vaccination, and this is called as live attenuated vaccination. That means this pathogen is still live, but it is attenuated, okay? It is attenuated, okay? You got me? Tell me, what did I tell you about vaccination? Okay. Yes, B cells begin to produce antibodies against it, and these antibodies will be present for the whole life, okay? Or for some period of time, like 5 years, 10 years. In those 5 years, any pathogen, if by chance is getting inside your body, these antibodies are present to kill this pathogen, okay? That's why we got immune to this pathogen for the 5 years, okay? This is the whole mechanism of vaccination. Now for suppose you put this inactive pathogen into the blood of the person, okay? So normally what B cells do, they secrete antibodies. Now if B cells are not mature enough to secrete antibodies, what will happen? This pathogen will roam around in your blood, okay? And at any time it can get activated and cause infection to your body, for suppose this got this inactivity, this inactivity thing, for suppose this was the inactivity line, this inactivity line got removed due to any stress, that means this pathogen is now able to roam around your body and this will cause infections. That's why we do not give live vaccines to a patient suffering from X-linked agammaglobulinemia. Okay, you got my point. Why don't know why the live vaccines are contraindicated? Because since B cells are not mature enough to secrete the antibodies, now we don't have to give live vaccines to a patient who is suffering from B cell deficiency. Okay. Yes, just because just or we can simply just yes, just we can say low circulating B cell or plasma cell count in blood. Okay, we can just simply say in XLA, that is a disease of BTK gene deficiency, there is low circulating B cells or plasma cells are actually mature. Plasma cells is a fancy name for the mature B cells. Okay, plasma cell count in the blood, that means if this is low, it will not be able to secrete antibodies against the vaccination. That's why you are just wasting your time by vaccinating a person, you are just vaccinating the resources of the country. Okay, that and this live vaccine could be dangerous to the patient, because this live vaccine is attenuated, for suppose this can get activated inside the body of a human. Okay, just because the neutralizing antibodies are not present there. Okay, should we move on to the question which is a UWorld question, or should we complete this first? I want to complete this first, because I want you to forget some things about this, that you can recall them again in the question. Right now you have got the fresh memory. After 10 to 15 minutes your memory will fade a bit. Okay, so I want you to check okay, that if you are attempting the question right or wrong, just keep this thing in mind: low circulating B cells, enteroviral infection, BTK gene deficiency, especially in the boys after 6 months, and one more thing which is very important: the live vaccine contraindicated. All these things which I have repeated once again are very important, are the buzzwords for any question. Okay, moving ahead. Since the B cells are responsible for producing antibodies, all the antibodies are produced from the only from the B cells. These B cells also produce an antibody that is called as IgA antibody. And in some patients, this IgA antibody is only deficient, while all other antibodies, the Gandhi you told me, okay, IgG, IgA, IgM, IgE, IgD, that means except IgA, all four antibodies are intactly present and intactly working in a patient. That is called as selective IgA deficiency. That means this patient will only be deficient from IgA, and the cause of this disease is unknown right now. But this is the most common primary immunodeficiency. Okay, this is the most common primary immunodeficiency, and selective IgA deficiency. That means selective. You have to just go through the terminology of the disease. This term is itself showing you that there is only selective IgA deficiency. There is only IgA deficiency in this disease, okay? And one thing I want to tell you more, that IgA is one of the antibodies that is secreted most commonly inside your body, that is secreted in most abundant amount in your body, okay? But it is secreted, it is excreted into the via the mucus or via the secretions out of the body. Like it is excreted via the breast milk, it is excreted via the tear drop, it is excreted via the sputum, it is excreted into the GI tract. That's why body has to produce more and more again and again this IgA. Okay, in one spit you are just excreting a lot of IgA antibodies, because you are just spitting out your mucus. Okay, moving ahead, majority of these patients are asymptomatic, but they can see airway and GI infections. We have discussed that the IgA is present in your mucous membranes, and two of your organ systems, one of them is airway, that is lung system, and one of them is GI tract. Both of these contain mucus in abundant amount, okay? That's why if IgA is deficient, that means these two systems are going to get infections, okay? Moving ahead, this is the presentation of this condition presents is autoimmune disease and shows the atopy. Atopy means genetic tendency to develop allergic rhinitis, asthma and dermatitis. And this could present, and one more thing is important here, that when this patient suffering from IgA deficiency will show anaphylaxis to IgA in the blood products, okay? So let me tell you one thing. First of all, this was donor A. First of all, your patient is recipient B, okay? This patient is suffering, recipient B is suffering from selective IgA deficiency, and this patient got motor vehicle accident, and now this patient needs blood supply. Now you have to provide blood to this patient. So what will you do? You will get his blood group checked, and after the matching of blood group, you will put this patient blood, okay? You will put in the blood into this patient from the donor A. But the donor A was a normal human being who has IgA, IgG, IgE, IgM and IgD, all antibodies in his blood. But right now, this recipient B has got just only IgG, IgM and IgE. For this patient, IgA is a foreign substance. That's why what this body will do, this body will secrete an immense immune response against this IgA, okay? And that condition will resemble anaphylaxis. So you got me here? Those patients who are suffering from IgA deficiency, if you are going to put them with the blood that is IgA, that is containing IgA, okay, those recipients will show, those suffering people will show anaphylaxis to this donor blood, because this blood contains IgA, that is like a foreign substance to this recipient body, okay? IgA is foreign, IgA seems like to this recipient body B, IgA seems like foreign substance, and it will secrete immune system, it will exaggerate immune system against IgA, okay? So this will present as anaphylaxis. Anaphylaxis is a serious condition in which patient gets serious allergy in his body, okay? Moving ahead, we have got, again, since this is selective IgA deficiency, we will see there is decreased IgA with normal IgG, IgM levels, because all the other antibodies are normal in this case, just only IgA is deficient. These patients have increased susceptibility to giardiasis. Giardiasis is a pathogen, is a bacteria, okay? I think it is a protozoa, I don't remember exactly. Okay, giardiasis is a pathogen which is found in hikings, okay? These patients who are suffering from IgA deficiency, right now am I audible to you? Okay, these patients who are suffering from IgA deficiency, they will be susceptible to giardiasis. Okay, giardiasis is the pathogen that is found in waterfalls and hikings, okay? You will see a scenario, or you will see a case where examiner will tell you that a group of four people went to a waterfall or went to hiking, and one of them developed chronic diarrhea, okay? One of them developed acute diarrhea, and that is going on for days and days, and that is not responding to normal antibiotics. That means you can suspect that this patient is suffering from IgA deficiency, because in IgA deficiency there is increased susceptibility to giardiasis that is found in the water of waterfalls or that is found in hiking space. Those tourists who are going for hikings can get this giardiasis infection, okay? Or you can just remember it as, can you just see, this is GIA IgA, just invert the words IgA, GIA, GIA, IgA, okay? Just I have kept this mnemonic in my mind, I GA is equal to GIA. Okay, and I have seen so many BCQs in my final year medicine, that there were so many BCQs which we have encountered around with this only this point, that GRDS is susceptibility is increased in these patients. Okay, going on, we can call, okay, just remember these things, because I will tell you that why these things are happening, but we will not go that much deep into this. Selective IgE deficiency, in this condition, can cause false negative celiac disease test. Okay, false negative means that means this patient is also suffering from celiac disease, but on laboratory test this will appear negative. Okay, the cause is still unknown, but you have to keep this thing in mind, that the patients who are suffering from selective IgE deficiency will show false negative celiac disease test. And since in these patients beta-HCG is raised, that's why they will show false positive serum pregnancy test. Okay, because in serum pregnancy test we measure this beta-HCG, which is found in abundant amounts that is not normally present in your body, because this is secreted by placenta or corpus callosum. Okay, that is going to develop in a pregnant female, but right now this female is not pregnant, but her beta-HCG levels are increased due to IgA deficiency. I don't know what the cause is behind that, but these two things happen, that false negative celiac disease, that means patient will be suffering from celiac disease, but still his or her testing will be negative, while there will be a positive pregnancy test, while female will not be pregnant. Okay, going on, then we have got an other disease, that is common variable immunodeficiency. That means in this immunodeficiency, this is going to be common and variable. Okay, this can have many presentations, right? Very variable is going in that sense. There is defect in, once again, B cell maturation, cause unknown in most cases, may present in childhood but usually diagnosed after puberty. So if you are going to see a 7-month old baby, 8-month old baby, 9-month old baby till 12 months, you are going to suspect XLA. If you are seeing a baby or a teen that is 13, 14 year old, then you have to go for common variable immunodeficiency. Okay, moving ahead, there is increased risk of autoimmune disease, bronchiectasis, lymphoma and sinopulmonary infections. While you can just see sinopulmonary infections in this baby or in this patient, but you are not going to see bronchiectasis and lymphoma like conditions in this baby. Okay, and once again, decreased plasma cells, because B cells are not going to mature or not going to differentiate, and we are going to see decreased immunoglobulins. Are we clear here? Okay, let's go to attempt a question, that is question number 55. Okay, let me just open this. Okay, 55. Okay, go on and attempt this question. Okay, let me make this normal once again.
feels leptomeningeal and is positive for enterovirus by PCR. So this patient would have been most likely to have the following. All right, so this patient was suffering from Bruton agammo
globulinemia.
Yeah, so there should be recurrent bacterial and entero, and the patient is 8 months, was 8 months, so reduced maternal IgG. So this has low circulating B lymphocytes.
Yes, yes, exactly.
Yeah, that's X-linked Bruton agammo globulinemia.
Because let me tell you one thing more. You are performing an autopsy. That means from the first word, you are just seeing that this condition is too much serious, because autopsy is performed on a dead person.
Okay.
An autopsy is performed on an 8-month-old baby. I already told you that baby will be just at the age of after 6 months, 7 month or 8 month infant. After his unexpected death, that means condition was so severe. Prior to death, the patient had a 1 month history of poor feeding and intermittent fever. That means earlier baby got properly feeded, but now he is not being able to feed. That means it has just started from 7 month. Okay. Intermittent fever, which progressed to severe lethargy and coma. That means condition has just involved his brain, because coma happens because of brain. The infant was adopted soon after the birth. Limited information or family history that how he was delivered. There is no information that how he was delivered and he was adopted. So we don't know his background condition, that whose his parents are actually. Brain biopsy reveals leptomeningeal inflammation. Once again, we are confirmed that there is inflammation in the brain. That means condition is so severe that brain got infected with enteroviral infection. Enteroviral infection is classically occurring in a disease that we have already discussed, that is XLA, X-linked agammaglobulinemia. Okay, Bruton X-linked agammaglobulinemia. We can just see here that we discussed enteroviral infections. Okay, I'm just going to make this red. Enteroviral infection, this, okay, this enteroviral infection is classical to this X-linked agammaglobulinemia, because enteroviruses are normally what happens to these viruses. These antibodies, first of all, this is IgG antibody, binds to these viruses so that they can call up complement, and these complement furthermore going to call the macrophages and neutrophils, and these macrophages are also going to call up T cells. That means whole immune system will get started, and that is dependent on this antibody itself. For suppose this antibody is not present, whole of this mechanism will not occur. Okay, that means this enterovirus will be still able to roam around in your body, in your blood, and if this has got reached your brain, that means that is going to be a very severe condition. Okay, this patient would have been most likely to which of the following laboratory findings. That means this patient is not producing antibodies. That means his B lymphocyte count is very low in the blood circulation. And now we have to, being a medical student, being a USMLE aspirant, you just have to have a knowledge about that why other options are incorrect. Okay, for suppose this first option, this is incorrect. Why? Abnormal dihydrorhodamine test is classical characteristic or a laboratory test for CGD, that is chronic granulomatous disease, in which NADPH oxidase deficiency occurs, and that is because that is going to lead to the catalase positive bacterial enzyme, not the viral enzyme. Okay, and that is deficiency, that is a defect in the neutrophils, because this NADPH is oxidase is present inside the neutrophils, and neutrophils are classical to kill the bacteria and fungi, not the viruses. To kill the viruses, you need T cells and B cells. Once again, going with the option B, absent peripheral neutrophils. If neutrophils are absent, that means there will be bacterial infection, not the viral infection. Eosinophils in the option C, these are responsible for the to kill the parasites, not the virus. Once again, you are now infected with virus, so you have to go for the T cell or B cell. Decreased total hemolytic complement. Okay, for suppose this complement is decreased, okay, but still this antibody is present in your body. Okay, should I just repeat this? I just already told you that this antibody binds to the pathogen, and then complement, this is the complement which is going to bind this antibody, then the whole mechanism starts. For suppose this antibody, this complement is not present while antibodies are present in your body, what will happen? These antibodies are still able to neutralize you. They are not able to destroy this pathogen, but they are still able to neutralize this pathogen, and they can call up on their cell, on then they can call up NK cells on their own self, okay, so that NK cells could come and destroy this pathogen. That means complement are required for the mechanism, for the whole this mechanism, but still antibody on its own self can neutralize this pathogen, okay. That means if the complement is not present in your body, this will not lead to death, okay. All these conditions are not that much severe that they can cause the death. They can cause a disease. For suppose we studied a disease that was SCID. Do you remember? SCID, severe combined immunodeficiency. In that disease, T cells were absent, okay. T cells were not going to be formed, or we discussed Dijon syndrome. In those conditions, T cells are not forming, but still your patient was able to live a life, okay, to live a life with that disease. That means that was not that much severe. However, B cells are also defective in SCID, but they are defective due to T cells, okay. They are not defective because of any gene. They are defective due to T cells, because T cells are not functioning properly. That's why B cells are also not functioning properly, but still B cells are present in the SCID and they are working in some extent. That's why the person with SCID is still able to live a successful life till 20 years, till 30 years. And if you are protecting that baby in a protected environment, you are keeping that baby in a bubble, that is called as bubble baby syndrome, okay, that baby will still be able to survive for some years, but this baby has died just at the age of 8 months. That means there is a serious condition, okay. Moving ahead, low circulating B lymphocyte count, this is our option, but right now leave this. Going to the option F, reduced serum IgG2 immunoglobulin levels, okay. This IgG2 immunoglobulin, if first of all only IgG immunoglobulin was not present while other immunoglobulins were present, the patient will not still going to die, okay. Patient is not going to die with only IgG deficiency. That here to for the death of the patient, to justify the death of the patient, you are going to attempt this option. That means low B cell count, that means antibodies are not present, that means no antibody is present in your blood, okay. Am I clear to you for this scenario? Just keep one thing in mind, to kill the viruses, there are two for the killing, for because your patient is right now suspected with virus, is infected with virus, okay. So to kill the virus, there are two cells, that are T cells and B cells, okay. B and T cells both are responsible to kill your viral, to kill the virus, to kill this virus, okay. But in these options, this dihydrorhodamine is related to catalase positive bacteria, this neutrophil is already related to bacteria, eosinophil is related to parasite, complement is related to this whole scenario, but still complement is not that much deadly, and IgG2 is still not that much deadly, while low circulating B lymphocyte count is deadly, because this is going to cause leptomeningeal inflammation. If brain inflammation has occurred, that means this is a very severe condition, okay. This is once again same thing, X-linked agammaglobulinemia. Pathophysiology means what is the mechanism behind the disease, that is BTK gene mutation resulting in defective Bruton tyrosine kinase, that is an enzyme that is responsible for the maturation of the B cells. Impaired B cell maturation and immunoglobulin production and clinical manifestations will be recurrent cyanopulmonary and gastrointestinal infections at the age of 3 to 6 months, okay, for the age greater than 3 to 6 months. Then moving ahead, chronic enteroviral infection could occur, small or absent lymphoid tissue, okay, that is tonsils and adenoids, both of these are present in your mouth. Moving ahead, laboratory findings will be decreased immunoglobulin content and antibody response to vaccines, okay. There will be no antibody response to vaccines. That's why vaccines are contraindicated, especially the live vaccines. On flow cytometry, you will see decreased CD19 plus B cells. CD19 is a receptor that is present on B cells. For example, this is a B cell, this CD19 is a receptor, okay? There are different kinds of receptor, but especially this CD19 receptor B plus B cells will be decreased on flow cytometry, and there will be normal T cells because this disease is not related to T cells, okay? Moving ahead, we have got treatment. Treatment is immunoglobulin replacement therapy. That means put the different kinds of immunoglobulins into that patient so that this patient can survive for some days or for some time. And prophylactic antibiotics if severe condition is there. Okay. Enterovirus is a common infection in children that typically causes self-limited disease such as harpingina, hand-foot and mouth disease, and in some cases aseptic meningitis. However, because neutralizing antibodies are required to clear the enterovirus, severe life-threatening infection can occur in infants with a primary humoral immunodeficiency such as X-linked agammaglobulinemia. Okay, moving ahead, X-linked agammaglobulinemia or Bruton agammaglobulinemia is due to a mutation in the BTK gene encoding Bruton tyrosine kinase. A defect in this protein prevents pre-B cells from differentiating and exiting the bone marrow. Therefore, patients have low circulating B lymphocyte count and low immunoglobulin level. Actually, this pre-B cell is a stage of B cell maturation. Okay, can you see this picture? In bone marrow, there is a hematopoietic stem cell. From that stem cell, pro-B cell arise. From that, pre-B cell get converted. And from here, immature B cell get arise, then transitional B cell, then in a spleen it is happening. Transitional B cell, mature B cell, activated B cell, memory B cell in the end, and plasma B cell. But for suppose this process got stuck here due to any reason, that reason is deficiency or defective tyrosine kinases. Okay, so this whole process will not happen and you will not be able to secrete, make this plasma cell, so and there will be no antibody secretion. Okay, and there will be no memory B cell present for the immune purposes. Okay, are we clear that this pre yes, from the pre B cell, for suppose these are the stages of B cell maturation: hematopoietic stem cell, pro B cell, pre B cell, then immature B cell. After immature B cell comes to the spleen, gets converted into transitional B cell and mature B cell. This mature B cell further gets activated in the lymph node or in the lymphoid tissue such as Peyer's patches, adenoids, tonsils. Okay, moving ahead, these activated B cells get converted into plasma cell for antibody secretion and into the memory B cell for future immune response. Okay, but for suppose this whole process got stuck here, so all this process will not happen, plasma cells will not get secreted, will not be formed, and memory cells will also not be formed. That means these both cells will not be present for the immune responses. Okay, we are just cutting this process here. Okay, so we have got these receptors. We just discussed the CD19. For suppose this is blue colored, this blue colored is CD19 receptor, this sky blue colored is CD20 receptor, then pre B cell receptor. Okay, this green colored is pre B cell receptor, this receptor IgM. Here, this is IgM receptor, this is IgD receptor, and these both receptors are going to get converted into these antibodies in future. Okay, these receptors are in a mature or immature B cell are going to make antibodies moving ahead. And we have got MHC class 2, which is present here in yellow color, Am I clear to you now? Okay, yes. Just remember don't just cram this. Just give have a concept that there is a maturation stage which is going to be halted, which is going to be stuck. Okay, which is going to stuck at one place. That's why B cell will not be able to make plasma cell and will not be able to secrete antibodies that are actually responsible to kill the different pathogens such as enterovirus. Okay, so going back to our previous slide, I want you to read this from here. In addition, go on.
It's so loud.
Okay.
All right. So in addition to enteroviral infection, SLA also increases the risk of recurrent pulmonary infections by encapsulated bacteria, e.g. Streptococcus pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenzae type B, which requires antibody opsonization or phagocytosis. Patients with impaired humoral immunity are also predisposed to gastrointestinal infections, such as Salmonella, Campylobacter, as well as chronic giardiasis, due to low secretory IgA.
Okay, now let me tell you one more thing.
It's airborne.
Okay, so what is happening normally? These are, for suppose, encapsulated organisms. These are encapsulated bacteria. Okay, these bacteria have capsules so that they can just escape the immune system. So what nature has done to these, nature has created these antibodies. What these antibodies are going to do, they are going to bind them and they are once again going to call up complement, and these complement will call up macrophages and neutrophils. Okay, so that they can destroy or eat this pathogen very easily, and whole this process is happening just because of this antibody. For suppose this antibody is not present here, now once again these pathogens, these encapsulated bacteria will roam around in your body and your macrophages will not be able to kill them. Okay, you will get again and again cyanopulmonary infections with Streptococcus pneumoniae and Haemophilus influenzae. Okay, you got my point now? Hello. Am I audible to you? Hello. What happened? I think there is a problem with your mic. You are talking but I cannot listen you. Hello. You are not audible to me. I cannot hear you. Okay. Should I refresh this? Let me refresh this. Okay, stay here. I'm going to refresh this. Can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me now? Hello? I think there is something problem at your side. I don't know what is it, but hello, what happened? Okay. Okay, I have muted you. Just go and unmute yourself.